quickly going to pull out some of the elements of this story structure, just go over it on a very simple level so it doesn't become too messy on this board, which I'm going to start to try and avoid doing from now on. Could be quite hard. We're going to go over, this is an Academy Award nominee best film, 2019. We're going to go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing a filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending, the state of affection, which is loss, becomes the state of infection, the loss phase, the limitations phase, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there or somewhere in between. If the events... if you do that, the events they tend to be referenced at later stages. And most stories end with some form of state of affection. If you want to end with infection, some combination, and that's almost irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, the various arcs, psychological journey. You're always going to have physical journey. You're always moving through new worlds, which really are physical manifestations of new psychological states and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated, they tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, you know it's a state of protection, repression, fear of it, etc. Those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you're here, you're not able to return. You have to grow, learn, mature, go forward, come all the way around until you're ready to return. So that's basic story architecture. Fundamental framework of all successful stories are based around. I go over that in great detail on the 2100 plus stage here of journey transformation, moving through new worlds and states you can purchase off the website. So let's go, let's get rid of that, let's draw another loop so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle would suggest. So this classic pattern, you can just in essence follow Cheney's arc. It depends how you cut it. For example, we've got him asking Rumsfeld, you know, what do you believe? And Rumsfeld laughs. I mean, there is no belief. And what happens here is that at the end of the road of trials phase, we benchmark a belief, and then in essence we gradually arc to lose all belief until we come back around to the end. From the sort of external change point of view, here he's starting with low status and or invisible, which is the classic formulation, and then he starts to become very visible, and at the end he reverses, so he's got a reverse position there, he reverses and he becomes very visible, as in effect the most powerful VP that's ever been, the de facto president. From the classical external arc point of view, he rises as he moves forward till we get to see the tangible sword stage where he in fact becomes the VP, the most powerful VP in history, and then he arcs down. So that's a tragic arc where in essence he loses his belief and incrementally all of those attachments which represent those beliefs. So here he gives up on the, you know, at the first threshold when Ford is made president and he becomes the advisor. His plan is to take over the world, but he gives that up at the end of the run of trials because his daughter Mary is gay. So that's an example of him benchmarking a belief. And in the end, he falls out with his daughter because he even lets go of that belief. So following the same process, it just depends on how you cut it and look at it. So initially, he's innocent and he's just an ordinary man, really. And we're going and we're going to turn him around and he's going to become an extraordinary man. That is given to him. So he got his classic call to adventure by his wife, Lynn, who I think doesn't actually believe anything here, doesn't at the end. And he aligns himself with her as he goes along, and he says, okay, I'm not going to be a nobody, I'm not going to live in a trailer park with nine kids, as Lynn is thinking her future is, doesn't want it, and so then he starts on this journey. He goes to become an intern in DC, he finds his mentor, which is Rumsfeld, and it's with Rumsfeld that he starts his movement forward. And by the way, at the season of the Tangible Sword, or Intangible Sword stage, that's when he starts to surpass his mentor. So if you look at the relationship between Rumsfeld, Cheney and Rumsfeld, you see here Rumsfeld, the clear mentor. Here now Rumsfeld sitting in as part of Cheney's inner set, but taking instructions from him all the way around until again he lets go of his mentor, betrays him, which is another form of attachment that he lets go, symbolizing the tragic arc down and you know, the loss of all those attachments which represented the beliefs he had. So the mentor, and then the things start to change. In other words, that world comes to an end. So Rumsfeld is given a dead-end job. Nixon resigns, but the first threshold is entered when we become advisor to Ford. And that's when we're going to start to take over the place. We remove our old, the old world order. So Kissinger is removed. But then ultimately, things come to an end when Carter is elected. Physical separation. He's trying to run for Congress, rising through the ranks, trying to develop some sort of belief. In fact, Lynn shows him the way. In other words, no belief, a kind of fake news, and he begins rising until that ambition is given up because of his daughter's gay, and that doesn't work in the Republican field. And then you get the call from Bush, and then ultimately becomes a de facto president or the most powerful DP. Then into the underworld, takes over the place. This is what he wanted to do in the beginning. Forms a government within the government. You've got him starting to turn and let go of every belief. So Colin Powell is a good guy, and he turns him to the dark side, if you want. You've got 9/11 at the Atonement, and then going into Iraq, so destroying other countries, just letting go of all sort of inhibitions and rules, laws, beliefs, anything that is worth standing for on the morality side, and this is becoming more and more the Antichrist. Let's go of his mentor, ultimately even let's go of his daughter until we come back round to him becoming the very visible, losing his heart, and that symbolism is prevalent throughout this. It starts the physical separation, so he starts having his heart attacks. The heart is lost, in essence, replaced, and that's symbolizing the loss of any sort of humanity that that he had. Anyway, that's the basic sort of breakdown, the basic coverage of that story. Again, I only go over these very quickly just to show that they do follow these this process. If you want a detailed deconstruction of this story, you can order it off the website. Otherwise, as I said, this process I go into in great detail in the 2100 plus stage of the Journey Transformation Movement Through New Worlds and States, which you can purchase.